Hello, I'm Rita Panahi reporting for Sky News Australia Digital. For years now, we have listened to lefties smear, ridicule and mock anyone who dared question the origins of COVID-19. You know, the virus that shut down our way of life and killed millions. The left subscribed to this idea that it just appeared in a wet market in China, perhaps from a dodgy bowl of bat soup. They wouldn't entertain any other explanation, especially after Donald Trump suggested a more nefarious possibility. And now, over 3 years since the pandemic began, the US Energy Department and FBI has finally conceded that COVID-19 most likely leaked from a Wuhan lab. Vindication for all those who had their eyes open the whole way through. But now let's take a walk down memory lane and expose all the people who use their various platforms to shut down debate and mock the Wuhan lab leak theory. Sky News Australia presents Digital Originals, Lab Leak Liars Exposed. 2020 saw the world place in a standstill when a new virus rapidly spread around the world. With little information and deaths rising, governments panicked and followed the Chinese Communist Party response, locking us in our houses until we knew more information about the coronavirus. As early as February 2020, a UK-based fact-checking outlet financed by Liberal billionaire George Soros tried to shut down claims that COVID-19 had leaked from a lab in China. Full Fact wrote, two Chinese scientists have published an article suggesting that the 2019 coronavirus outbreak could have originated from bats in a lab in Wuhan. However, apart from maps showing the proximity of labs, they offer no evidence to prove this. And never one to skip a beat, the Washington Post wrote, Tom Cotton keeps repeating a coronavirus conspiracy theory that it was already debunked. Senator Tom Cotton repeated a fringe theory suggesting that the ongoing spread of a coronavirus is connected to research in the disease-ravaged epicenter of Wuhan, China. In response to Cotton's remarks, as well as in previous interviews with the Washington Post, numerous experts dismissed the possibility the coronavirus may be man-made. 15 months later, the Washington Post finally offered a correction. Earlier versions of this story and its headline inaccurately characterised comments by Senator Tom Cotton regarding the origin of the coronavirus. The correction read at the top of the report, the term debunked and the Post use of conspiracy theory have been removed because then, as now, there was no determination about the origins of the virus. The truth is that the most logical explanation of the origin of COVID-19 was dismissed because it came from, yep, you guessed it, Donald Trump. President Trump was dismissed as a racist for even suggesting that COVID-19 came from China.
In this country, your own aide, Secretary Azar, says he does not use this term. He says ethnicity does not cause the virus. Why do you keep using this?
Because it comes from China.
A lot of people say it's racist.
It's not racist at all, no, not at all. It comes from China. That's why. Comes from China. I want to be accurate. Yeah, please, John. Please. I have great love for all of the people from our country. But as you know, China tried to say at one point, maybe they stopped now, that it was caused by American soldiers. That can't happen. It's not going to happen. Not as long as I'm president. It comes from China.
It is. Have you seen anything at this point that gives you a high degree of confidence that the Wuhan Institute of Virology was the origin of this virus?
Yes, I have. Yes, I have. And I think that the World Health Organization should be ashamed of themselves because they're like the public relations agency for China. And this country pays them almost $500 million a year, and China pays them $38 million a year. And whether it's a lot or more, it doesn't matter. It's still. They shouldn't be making excuses when people make horrible mistakes, especially mistakes that are causing hundreds of thousands of people around the world to die.
From media to supposed experts across each and every network, it was hard to find an open mind to this idea that the virus could have started in a lab. You know, the one in Wuhan that studied coronaviruses?
The lab leak theory from the Wuhan lab was discussed in some of your emails. Dr. Collins, the head of the NIH, seemed to suggest it was a conspiracy. Did you agree at that time in April of 2020 that the lab leak theory was a conspiracy theory?
No, not necessarily at all. The situation is that we didn't know, and we still don't know, what the origin is. That if you look historically and the way things rolled out, we all felt, and still do actually, Willie, that it is more likely to be a natural jumping of species from an animal reservoir to a human. Was there really more evidence? The evidence is very sparse, and that's the reason why we want to keep looking. The evidence for one or the other. If you look historically, the way things have rolled out, the original SARS-CoV-1, MERS, Ebola, the diseases that emerge from a reservoir in an animal, it happens all the time. And that's the reason why we feel that's the most likely.
It's quite clear in this case that it came across through animals. Mm-hmm. And almost all our diseases, like HIV, crossed over from chimpanzees in Africa quite some time ago. Ebola came from bats. This also, with one step in between, came from bats. So it's going to keep happening, particularly with climate change, where we're invading a lot of...
You know one thing about former President Trump and some Republicans here who seem to be almost taking a victory lap with the idea, because their theory that the virus may come from a lab, that this proves that they were, quote, right all along. That's not what President Trump said when he was first in office. In fact, we at the AP reported way back in January 2020, just as this virus was starting to come out onto the world stage, and it was starting to become a concern here in the United States before it really exploded here, that then President Trump was leery about talking about the virus, sure, for fear of rattling the stock market, but also for fear of upsetting China, because he was so desperate to get a new trade deal done with China. He thought a deal with President Xi, working with Beijing, would allow him to have something that could be part of his re-election campaign, be part of his re-election plank there. And he was leery for months of upsetting China. He eventually, of course, took very harsh rhetoric to Beijing, but right now he and his allies are practicing some revisionist history.
And the scientists aren't the only ones rankled today by Trump's effort at reputational repair. The New York Times also advances recent reporting on U.S. intelligence agencies, which we learned this week provided intel in the president's PDB as early as January about the lethal spread of COVID. Those same agencies now have been tapped with investigating one of Trump world's most favorite conspiracy theories. New York Times reports this, quote, senior Trump administration officials have pushed American spy agencies to hunt for evidence to support an unsubstantiated theory that a government lab in Wuhan, China was the origin of the coronavirus outbreak. That's according to current and former American officials. The effort comes as President Trump escalates a campaign to blame China for the pandemic. Some intel analysts are concerned that the pressure from the administration officials will distort assessments about the virus and that they could be used as a political weapon in an intensifying battle with China over a disease that has infected more than 3 million people across the globe. The stories of Trump reaching deep into the government agencies charged with science.
Hey, Dr. Walensky, I want to ask you finally about one more thing. The president ordered this U.S. intelligence agencies to investigate the origins of the coronavirus. Does the administration now believe that this could have been leaked from a lab in Wuhan?
I think the administration now believes that it's really important to understand the origin of this. Certainly, we know that most coronaviruses, when they enter into human disease, have come from animal sources. But I think it's really important now to understand where this came from and to so we can prevent further epidemics, pandemics like this in the future.
So is it a possibility that it may have originated in this lab?
I think we know, we have seen in the initial WHO report that there are numerous possibilities as to where it originated, and the really important thing is to collaborate as a globe to understand its origin.
And of course, print media took the side of anyone but Trump. Politico wrote, In recent days, President Donald Trump's allies have seized upon an alternate origin story for the novel coronavirus, that the disease emerged from inside a Chinese laboratory, not an outdoor market. The basic narrative reads like a dystopian movie plot and goes something like this. Somehow the virus escaped from a lab in Wuhan, the Chinese city where the disease first appeared in late 2019. Researchers there were studying dangerous bat coronaviruses, and safety procedures at the facility were not as rigorous as they should have been. The Truth Factory over at CNN penned, "Now, before we play the game of he said, he said, remember this, only one of these two people is a world-renowned infectious disease expert, and it's not Donald Trump. In short, Fauci's view on the origins of the disease matters a whole lot more than Trump's opinion about where he came from, especially because outside of Trump and his immediate inner circle, most people in a position to know are very, very sceptical of the Trump narrative that the virus came out of a lab, whether accidentally or on purpose." In May of 2020, National Geographic had this splash: "Anthony Fauci says no scientific evidence the coronavirus was made in a Chinese lab." Classic Fauci. PolitiFact had a field day with the claim that COVID-19 originated in a lab, calling such claims debunked conspiracy theories, slamming an interview Fox News host Tucker Carlson conducted with virologist and former postdoctoral fellow at the University of Hong Kong, Dr. Li Meng Yan. PolitiFact labelled Dr. Yan's statement "pants on fire." Facebook then labelled the video on its platform as false information, further stating in the label that the post repeats information about COVID-19 that independent fact-checkers say is false. Scientists have two plausible explanations for the origin of the virus: natural selection in an animal host or natural selection in humans after the virus jumped from animals, said PolitiFact. Our friends at the New York Times, they said the other actual crisis is a once-in-a-century pandemic that has killed at least 600,000 people in the US. The effort to spin up outrage over the Wuhan lab leak theory, to blame China entirely for all of those deaths, is clearly an effort to try to make Americans forgive Trump for his mishandling of the coronavirus by convincing them it was all a Chinese plot. For the most pro-Trump partisans, that's a slam dunk. For everyone else, it's probably a stretch. Even if it is somehow proved that the coronavirus was invented in a Chinese lab, its spread in the United States was far more the fault of Trump than of Xi Jinping. And as late as August 2022, when we knew so much more about the origins of COVID, The Conversation wrote, "The COVID lab leak theory is dead. Here's how we know the virus came from a Wuhan market." And they weren't alone in pushing that narrative in Australia. We had our own brigade of crazy who were unable to admit there could have been another possibility. Paul Barry, host of the taxpayer-funded public broadcaster's Media Watch program, was a vocal critic of the Wuhan lab leak theory.
How likely is it that the virus escaped from that Chinese lab? Well, in short, it's not.
COVID-19 did not come from lab.
The evidence is overwhelming.
Last month, two studies published in Science magazine, after 5 months of peer review, identified the wild animal trade at the Wuhan wet market as ground zero for the COVID outbreak. The siren has definitely sounded on the lab leak theory. He hoped the new evidence would correct the false record that the virus came from a lab. Meanwhile, Sky News host Gary Hargrave had his own crazy theory about the global health emergency.
This thing has been cooked up, it's pretty evident, cooked up by some mad scientists in China. I don't care what anyone says.
Now, after years of evidence mounting, the US Energy Department and the FBI have finally conceded that the virus most likely began in the lab.
I asked you also back then about the investigation to COVID origins. Is the FBI in charge of the investigation of the origins of the coronavirus?
We certainly have a role in looking into the origins of the coronavirus.
Now there's this Department of Energy study that says it's likely to have come from a lab leak, although the confidence is low. It cites the FBI. What is the determination by the FBI?
So, as you note, Brett, the FBI has for quite some time now assessed that the origins of the pandemic are most likely a potential lab incident in Wuhan. Let me step back for a second. You know, the FBI has folks, agents, professionals, analysts, virologists, microbiologists, et cetera, who focus specifically on the dangers of biological threats, which include things like novel viruses like COVID, and the concerns that, in the wrong hands, some bad guys, a hostile nation state, a terrorist, a criminal, the threats that those could pose. So here you're talking about a potential leak from a Chinese government-controlled lab that killed millions of Americans, and that's precisely what that capability was designed for. I should add that that our work related to this continues, and there are not a whole lot of details I can share that aren't classified. I will just make the observation that the Chinese government seems to me has been doing its best to try to thwart and obfuscate the work here, the work that we're doing, the work that our U.S. government and close foreign partners are doing, and that's unfortunate for everybody.
And of course, the Biden administration are still unable to admit that Trump's presumption was in fact correct.
The president made trying to find the origins of COVID a priority right when he came into office, and he's got a whole of government effort designed to do that. There is not a consensus right now in the U.S. government about exactly how COVID started. There is just not an intelligence community consensus. And I would add that one of the things the president did was he's the one who tasked the national labs, which report up through the Department of Energy, to study this as well. So it wasn't just an effort that was confined to the intelligence community.
You said that right now there is not a consensus. Will there ever be a definitive answer from the Biden administration on the origins of COVID-19? And how much of that is dependent on cooperation from China?
We really do want to know what happened here, because the president wants to make sure that we're postured to prevent any future pandemics, or if not prevent them, to be able to get farther along ahead of them. So we're working very hard to understand this as best we can. Again, there's just no consensus across the government. The work continues, and I'm not going to get ahead of conclusions that haven't been arrived at yet.
Just one last quick follow-up. What agency is taking the lead on this?
This is a whole of government effort, and clearly here at the National Security Council, I mean, we're running the interagency process on this, but it's a whole of government effort.
How will the president respond to China, though, if it's determined that they lied about all this and now are trying to paint the administration as in such a negative light? How will he respond to Xi and
Well, let's not get ahead of where we are in the process right now. There is not a consensus on what caused COVID to start. The president wants to understand that so we can prevent better future pandemics. He's made that a priority, and we don't have an answer to speak to. And so given that we don't have a consensus, it would be foolish for me to get out ahead of speculation on hypothetical situations to come. We just aren't there yet.
I do want to speak to Dr. Fauci, because the political attacks on someone like Dr. Fauci, who and public officials more broadly, but Dr. Fauci, who has spent his career saving lives, whether it was the AIDS epidemic or as we are just coming out of this COVID, this once-in-a-generation pandemic, these attacks have been counterproductive. They have not been helpful.
Are there any plans for the administration to release an unclassified version of the Energy Department's origins COVID origin report? And if not, why is the administration choosing to keep that assessment classified?
So again, I'm going to just repeat my National Security Council colleague, who said that he don't want to get ahead of don't want to confirm a story, so I'm not certainly not going to answer that from here. What I can tell you and reiterate from here, as he has said, as the National Security Advisor has said many times on the airwaves yesterday, which is that the president wants to get to the bottom of this because he thinks it's incredibly important to figure out, to get a sense of where COVID-19 originated from.
And for a bit of light relief, American comedian Jon Stewart didn't back down from pointing out the obvious.
What do you mean by that? Do you mean like perhaps there's a chance that this was created in a lab, there's an investigation?
A chance?
Well, but if there's evidence, I'd love to hear it.
There's
a
novel respiratory coronavirus overtaking Wuhan, China. What do we do? Oh, you know who we could ask? The Wuhan novel respiratory coronavirus lab. The disease is the same name as the lab. That's just a little too weird, don't you think? And then they ask those scientists, they're like, how did this... So wait a minute, you work at the Wuhan respiratory coronavirus lab. How did this happen? And they're like, a pangolin kissed a turtle. And you're like, no, if you look at the name, let me see your business card. Show me your business card. Oh, I work at the coronavirus lab in Wuhan. Oh, because there's a coronavirus loose in Wuhan. How did that happen? Maybe a bat flew into the cloaca of a turkey and then it sneezed into my chili and now we all have coronavirus. Like, come on.
Wait a second.
All right.
John.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. There's been an outbreak of chocolatey goodness near Hershey, Pennsylvania. What do you think happened? Like, oh, I don't know, maybe a steam shovel mated with a cocoa bean. Or it's the chocolate factory. Maybe that's it.
That could be.
If you found this production informative, then please like, subscribe, and share this video. We also want to hear your thoughts on the issue, so write us a comment down below before you click off this page. I'm Rita Panahi from Sky News Australia. Thank you for watching.